Welcome to Disney Odd Pod.
I'm Kat.
I'm Dee.
And this week, it's a lesson in bad decisions and why you should not be a virgin. Disney's message for you.
Is that... What? Hocus Pocus, 1993.
Jump back. Twist the bones and bend the back.
Eat it, Captain Malachimist.
Back in 1693, the people of Salem, Massachusetts...
Witches!
Yes? Thought they got rid of the Sanderson sisters for good.
We shall be back!
300 years later, it's Halloween Eve, and they're back.
Uh-oh.
We are home!
Are you broads a little old to be trick-or-treating?
We're talking about three-ancient hags versus the 20th century. How bad can it be?
Now they're digging up old friends. And running amok. Looking for the one thing they miss most.
You stay for supper.
I'm not hungry.
But we are.
Only one boy has the power to stop them.
Prepare to die again!
You have no powers here, you fool!
Before all Salem falls under their spell.
I am gonna tell you!
I'm just saying, if Zach was not a virgin, none of this would have happened. So what is Disney trying to say? Don't be a virgin and then you won't have problems.
How about if you weren't... How about don't play with fire?
Well, that... Yeah, that too. That too. But I'm just like, what is this? There was so much emphasis on... Like, every other scene was like, oh, he's a virgin.
I think they were just trying to dunk on him.
Dead and lit by a virgin on Halloween night.
What happened?
A virgin lit the candle.
So for three centuries, I guarded the house on All Hallows Night when I knew some airhead virgin might light that candle.
Brave little virgin who lit the candle.
Okay, let's get on the sidewalk.
And he's a virgin.
Are you a virgin?
Yeah.
Really?
Look, I'll get a tattoo on my forehead, okay?
Come here.
What?
This can't hear Binx, right? He can talk. My brother's a virgin. He lit the black flame candle.
Thackary Binx, what took thee so long?
I'm sorry, Emily. I had to wait 300 years for a virgin to light a candle.
Yeah.
That's what it sounded like to me.
So, okay. For some reason, you'd never seen this movie in its entirety before today.
Yeah, or really probably at all.
Which is just baffling, because I've seen it 5 million times.
I think I was confusing this in The Witches of Eastwick.
Oh, yeah, that's a good movie, too. So what are your initial thoughts?
It's all right. There's a lot of weird choices. I think that this movie relies a lot on nostalgia.
Oh, my God. Okay, I fully admit it. This movie is so nostalgic. There are so many things about this movie that really aren't that funny.
Yes.
But I find them... I find them absolutely hysterical.
And there's a lot of weird jump cuts where they clearly cut a whole bunch of stuff out. And it's like, well, that doesn't make a ton. I mean, I get where they're coming from, but they skipped A to, they just went A to C instead of A, B, C or A to D. And it's like, what the fuck just happened there for a minute?
It is a weirdly put together movie.
Yeah.
And, like, I acknowledge it's not some great mass cinematic masterpiece.
Right, so watching it at my age under the purview of doing this, it's not that great. It's okay.
I understand that, but...
no, I'm just saying, I knew I wasn't going to be able to match your energy of, like, oh my god, I love it. No, because it's not... It's just, it's very weird.
I recognize this, but that's kind of why I like it, I think, because it is kind of a weird movie, and it's just, there's a lot of very small things in the movie that are funny, that if you're not paying attention, you don't catch them, and then you do catch it on, like, the 10th watch through.
Gotcha.
But...
And it's just funny that Thora Birch becomes a worse actor the older she gets.
Oh, you mean because she's, like, super cute in this movie?
Yeah, she's really good in this, and then...
You're my kitty now. You'll have milk and tuna fish every day. And you'll only hunt mice for fun.
You're going to turn me into one of those fat, useless, contented house cats.
You betcha. Yeah. You know, Binx, I'll always take care of you. My children will take care of you, too. and their children after that.
Like, okay in American Beauty, and then, like, pretty bad in Ghost World, and then she just kind of goes away.
I've never seen Ghost World. You talk about that movie all the time.
Because it's a hipster movie from my exact age that had her and, what's her... Fingled.
Oh, Scarlett Johansson?
Yeah, Scarlett Johansson when she was like probably her first movie. First time anybody saw her, really.
So it was like one of those movies that people saw and immediately they were like, oh, you're a hipster douche.
Wait, no, it was a hipster movie.
But that's what I mean. People...
Because it was based on like a comic booky kind
of
thing.
But that's what I'm saying. It's that movie that's not that great of a movie, but everybody saw it and they were like, oh my god, Ghost World. Oh my god, Ghost World.
It is not a good movie.
So it's like, like people my age... To my equivalent of that is Garden State.
Yeah, it's very much in that
people
range.
Love
yeah.
Garden State, and it's a really not that great of a fucking movie.
But maybe even a little bit further underground than Garden State.
Okay, I guess I'll read the synopsis here. So, Snaps. You can watch this on Disney Plus, obviously.
I wouldn't say obviously. Any of these movies could not be on there.
The only reason I've seen this movie so many times is because they played it nonstop, like, the entire month of October on Disney Channel.
That checks out.
Obviously, they're going to have it on Disney Plus. People would riot in the streets if this was not on Disney Plus.
Burn the Disney!
Hocus Pocus. Family, comedy, fantasy. You're in for a devil of a time with three outlandishly wild witches. Bette Midler, Sarah Jessica Parker, and Kathy... Najimy. Return from 17th century Salem after they're accidentally conjured up by some unsuspecting pranksters. It's a night full of zany fun and comic chaos once the tricky 300-year-old trio set out to cast a spell on the town and reclaim their youth. But first they must get their act together and outwit three kids and a talking cat. Contains tobacco description. Gary Marshall's cameo character smoking? Is that who was smoking?
Oh, yeah, maybe, yeah. No, his wife.
Oh, it was Penny his Marshall, wife. That's yeah. right. Yeah, which is just, spoiler, my favorite part of the entire movie.
Yeah, absolutely. That's the best part of the movie.
It's so fucking funny. Okay.
So, we'll get to that later.
Our director, Kenny Ortega.
From Newsies.
But really, his most famous thing is the High School Musical series. That's his big thing. Because that is a big thing. A lot of people watch that, including your wife did watch that. It was a thing. When I was in high school.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. It was a High School Musical thing.
It was a thing. And the Descendants series on Disney Channel, which I haven't seen. But that's a big thing for kids younger than me.
And he kind of started doing a lot of music videos, which is really funny.
There was a lot of music videos I saw. And like a bunch of Michael Jackson like tribute stuff. Like Michael a documentary Jackson. Thing.
It's in me.
None of it's true. It's BS. They made it up.
So ignorant.
And so the main writer, David Kirshner, is the creator of Fievel.
Yeah, American Tale, which is the greatest.
And Fievel Goes West.
Fievel Goes West, it kicks ass. That is the best movie.
That's what I was watching instead of some dumbass, what's the other mouse movie that I didn't like as much?
Great Mouse Detective?
Yeah.
Well, I also...
I was more of a Fievel guy.
We had both in our house, but we also had his other movie, The Pagemaster, which is it has a Macaulay Culkin. It's like half animated, half live action type thing. But it's really good. But no, so he knows his way around a movie.
A movie and some children.
And he knows his way around children. And then the other two writers, Mick Garns and Neil Cuthbert, they didn't really do much.
Come on, the Neil Cuthbert guy did Pluto Nash, the worst Eddie Murphy movie ever made.
Have you seen that?
Some of it. It's bad.
I don't even know what it is. Is he supposed like?
He's like a superhero of some kind. It's really bad.
I've never seen it.
It's really, really bad.
I have seen his other movie, Mystery Men, but that's not a great movie either. It's pretty stupid.
Yeah. So then, obviously, we have Bette Midler as Winnie.
Yes.
I will ask thee one final time.
Yes.
What hast thou done with my son, Thackary?
Thackary. Mm.
Answer me.
Well, I don't know. That's got my tongue.
Sanderson.
She's so good in this part. She's amazing. And we also, of course, saw her in Oliver and Company. She was the voice of the fancy dog.
Georgette.
And she, you know, she's Bette Midler. She
does music.
She's like Barbara Streisand. They're like the same, they're like two sides of the same coin to me.
Yeah, she's the ugly side.
Really? I think that she's more attractive than Barbara Streisand.
But everybody else would say that Barbara Streisand's more. That's all I'm saying.
Really?
For sure, definitely.
I don't know. I I adore Bette Midler. I think she's very funny. I think she's great.
Right. None of that says she's hot.
Okay. Beside the point.
And then Mary, Kathy Najimy, or Peggy Hill.
Is she Peggy Hill?
Yeah, she's Peggy Hill. That's what she's most known for.
Happiness. 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 Penis. I did it. Ovaries. Uvula. Uterus. Vagina!
That's amazing. Okay, I had no idea because I was like, why does this lady seem more famous than I think? Than I don't recognize anything that she's in, and I just missed the
kingdom. Well, you haven't seen Sister Act?
No, I have never seen Sister Act. Which is, I guess, weird that I've never seen it.
Why would you have seen it? You weren't alive when it... Well, you were a child. Young child when it came
here,
out.
Here, toddler, watch Sister Act.
Yeah, watch Whoopi.
And this might be the most enjoyable Sarah Jessica Parker, other than Sex and the City, but I love her character in this movie.
Wow, I could not disagree more.
What? I think she is so much.
Terrible, and she overacts every single
but
scene.
That's the why she's so great.
And it's just like, get off the fucking screen, bitch.
No, I love
this
her.
This isn't about you. Go away.
I've seen you so much more recently because Hocus Pocus is literally...
Right, I'm sorry about that. I know it's like on a lot.
Don't apologize.
It's the season.
It's the best.
My daughters like it, but they you know, they've only seen it a couple times.
My kids have seen it like 10 times
this
week.
Sorry, God.
No, it's honestly. Okay, cool. No, I just to finish my thought, it's crazy what it's become. It's weird it's 25 years
late. Isn't that funny? Who would have thunk? No, I've only seen the movie once. It's very likely, no, it's certain that everybody who else, you know, others know it far better than I do.
Oh, my daughter.
I have very specific memories of the making of the movie, but not as much the story of the movie. Do you know what I mean?
I do.
I just don't recall the plot.
She's running amok. Amok.
She's just dumb. Every single part
That's the point.
Dumb.
She's supposed to be dumb.
No, I understand. I understand that her character's supposed to be dumb. I get it. But it's so over the top and overdone that it's just like, what are we doing here?
I love her.
I realized watching this, she absolutely cannot act.
So it's really.
She can be.
She got better herself. As she got older.
She can be herself.
Well, because Sex and the City, she is just being herself.
And that's it.
But so there. A lot of her younger parts are very strange.
I don't think she has a lot of younger parts. Okay, if you look through her thing, she really doesn't have that many parts, period.
No, but there's a movie called Girls Just Want to Have Fun where she enters a dance competition.
Oh my God.
And, like, the guy in the movie, his dad, like, gives up his job to, like, you go win that dance contest, son. It's the most ridiculous 80s movie. But no, she's been in, you know, and she was in that Square Pegs TV show or whatever that was on for, like, 20 episodes and then got canceled.
Wasn't she? She was in that one movie that we saw, right? Like the one about the space.
The
thing?
Rocketeer. Or no, not Rocketeer.
Yeah,
Rocketeer.
No.
So, Flight of the Navigator.
Oh, yeah, Flight of the Navigator.
Yeah, she was like.
The nurse, the punk rock
nurse.
Yeah,
that should have been the younger girl that he had a crush on growing up.
If she, when we fixed that movie, I remember.
Yeah. And that's, I think, her only other Disney part.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think she has any other ones. And then the main guy, Max.
Omri Katz.
He was on Dallas, like, as a kid actor, I guess.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, that's it.
Which is just odd, because he looks like one of those generic...
I swear I recognized him, but no.
This is the only thing I recognize
I
him
also
from.
Swear I recognized Allison, who's Vanessa Shaw. I don't have... I mean, she did Corky Romano, like, really?
I get her and Allie Larder confused
lot. I think that might be the person I'm thinking of.
Allie Larder does a ton of movies, and she's always, like, really hot or whatever. Her and Allie Larder look a lot alike.
But is she hot?
She's supposed to be hot. Like, that's, like, they have similar, like, facial features, and their hair is very similar, okay. And their eyes are really similar.
Because I just swear that I knew who this gal was, and I was like, oh, no, I don't.
The only thing that I remember her from is there's a really weird movie with Josh Hartnett called 40 Days and 40 Nights, and she plays his psychotic ex-girlfriend.
Oh my god, Josh Hartnett is the worst.
He's not the worst.
Really? What movie has he been in lately?
He was in, that one movie that was in that thing. Like,
as soon as he started to get, like, mildly not young, it just all fell apart, like, immediately.
It did fall apart for him a little bit, but that's fine.
Like, because his eyes started to get a little more squinty, and he wasn't hot dude as much anymore. It was like, you're gone.
But see, he's kind of like one of the guys, like, when I was a young teen.
Oh, I'm sure, yeah.
He was considered very hot when I was a young teen.
So I was like, oh, Pearl Harbor.
You'd be quiet about Pearl Harbor. And then the only other one I wanted to call out was the guy who plays the dad, Charles Rocket. He's the bad guy in Dumb and Dumber, like the main bad guy.
Oh, that's where I recognized him from. Okay.
And we'll see him again in Tom and Huck.
Wow. Hopefully we never see Tom and Huck, but no, I'm just kidding.
he had a very small part in this movie, but...
Did you get any fun facts?
I had a couple. One that was very fun. Leonardo DiCaprio was originally going to play Max's part, but he...
No, he wasn't going to originally do anything.
No, listen.
No, he just turned it down.
He turned it down to play Gilbert Grape.
Gilbert Grape. All of these are just like, even though I finally picked one this time because I found one that was very fun... But I just, all the hypothetical ones are just
those are the fun facts.
No, because they're not facts. It's not a fact that he was going to do this. He turned it down for...
But that's a fun
Lord
fact.
Lord knows whatever reason.
It's like, oh my god, can you imagine what that would be like?
I could offer Leonardo DiCaprio to do this podcast. That doesn't mean it was ever a real thing.
It was a real thing in our heads. Oh. Don't make that kind of threat.
Cloris Leachman was the first choice for Winnie.
I also had that. The producer, which is just... No.
Yes.
No, this
no.
part
Fuck you.
Is Bette Midler.
That would be the best alternate timeline for this. Crazy Cloris. Or she would have been a better Sarah Jessica
Parker. She would have been a better Sarah Jessica Parker. Consistently horny. Like the horny...
Yeah,
all
the
horny,
time. Yeah. And she would have actually been funny, which would have really helped.
I think that...
Because Kathy and Jimmy's funny. Bette Midler's funny. Sarah Jessica Parker, not funny.
Well, we disagree on that fact,
yeah,
but...
I don't know what blinders you have on, but...
Nostalgia.
Yeah, because she's not good or funny in this.
This was released in July of 1993.
I had the same thing. I was like, what the fuck? Why the... And it says because they didn't want it to compete with...
Nightmare Before Christmas.
Nightmare Before Christmas, but really?
It's a Halloween. It's a Halloween movie.
I understand.
Which they should have released in November because it's debatable whether it's Halloween or Christmas, and they could have released this in early October.
They should have released this at the beginning of October, and they should have released Nightmare Before Christmas the day after Halloween.
Or in mid-November or Thanksgiving.
No, you don't have to go that far. Keep it close, but... Or just late October. Like, come on, what, July? No wonder I'd never heard of this or seen it or anything.
It was in July.
July, yeah, let's go watch this instead of, like, I'm trying to think of something else that would have come out, and then, like, True Lies or something like that. Oh, Batman and Robin.
Oh my god. So, the kid who plays Max, this was on some chick that he was dating at the time, I forgot to write her name down, said this on a podcast. He cheated on her with Vanessa Shaw. So they were getting down for real behind the scenes in this movie.
That's no surprise.
They're just two teenagers. So he's not a virgin off the screen, but he's got to play one on the screen. What a good actor.
The devil dog was Kathy and Jimmy's dog. That's all.
Oh, the devil dog. It's pretty fucking cute.
All right. Do you want to...
So are we going to cast our way through this? Like cast a spell? Light a candle?
Light a candle for your adventure through one night in a town of Salem.
I would say cast.
Cast.
Resurrect.
It's a lot of flying.
Fly? I just feel like that's so, like, used for so many things.
Fly by.
I say resurrect.
Okay.
We're going to resurrect our way through this. Vacuum, mop, whatever.
Thank you.
Binx wakes up and we're in like 1700s, 1800s.
Well, if you follow the logic, it's 1693.
Okay, sorry. I don't know the exact date of the Salem witch trials.
Well, no, they said it was 300 years before. It was 1993, so it's 1693.
Okay, you're right. Math.
Yeah. Math. It's what's for dinner.
Not for me. I'm not hungry for that. He wakes up and his sister's missing and he's like, oh my god, Emily, where are the Emily? Because he talks with a British accent for some reason.
Well, they would have been early
settlers. I guess that's true. Yeah. They would have been settlers to, okay, fair. Yeah. Fair. So his parents would have had a British, okay. That, and then it just slowly petered out.
Yeah.
Which is interesting. Why would it just, everybody just keep having British accents?
So apparently what I've actually heard when it comes to the languages is that we speak more like the British spoke then, even not like with the thou, this, thou's, but our accent, the American accent, is what British people sounded like then. But they've morphed the language more.
To be more like
what they sound like now.
Because they're probably merging with more like Scottish and that kind of thing?
No. Because they are like the inventors of the language, so they screw with it more than us, who have like kept it really rigid.
Okay.
That's one thing I've
heard. So they just decided to make it fun.
Yeah, and we don't make it as fun. And it just
stuck.
Yeah.
Interesting. Thackary Binx. So they lured Emily, which it's not really clear why she's the only child, if she's out singing this song, to lure all the children, whereas later in the movie there's a million children that get lured there, but here she's the only child.
Wait, Emily?
Yes.
Well, there might not have been very many children back then.
She's the only one.
Well, only one, like, close by, yeah.
Well, and it's not clear, like, when does somebody stop being a child, exactly.
Well, according to this, it was, like, pretty old, because Max at 16 was old enough to be a child.
But that's what I'm saying, so you think that Thackary Binx would have also been lured?
Maybe.
But it...
Maybe he was too far away from the call or whatever.
Bewitched Emily, and they're going to make a potion because they're really old and they have to suck the lives out of children to stay young.
Yeah, that's what I was confused about at first. I was like, why do they look so old? And then I was like, oh, okay. Yeah. So they suck the life out of Emily.
Because Thackary Binx can't save her, but he does get turned into a cat in the process.
A black cat. But Thackeray's family catches the witches and hangs them.
Right. And okay, here is one of the biggest plot holes in this entire movie. Why can he not talk to his dad? He can talk in the future, so is it because, like, he just got turned into a cat, he couldn't figure it out?
Maybe it took him forever to figure out how to talk.
Because it doesn't make any sense when you think about it. He just talks like his normal voice in the future, but now he's trying to communicate with his dad.
I could see it taking him 300 years to figure out how to talk.
They should have explained that in some way.
I guess, yeah.
In some way. Fair enough. Didn't you ever ask for help or something? And then he could have been like, it took me this many years to figure out how to talk or something. Because that's always bothered me about this movie. But before they die, Winifred casts a spell that says, we're going to, on a full moon on Halloween, a virgin's going to light this candle. Which, why wouldn't you just get rid of the candle?
Yeah, burn it that night.
Burn the candle, or like... Not
It's probably unable to be destroyed or something.
Or chop it up. Well, I guess that's true. But it just, you know, magic.
Magic. And then we meet the California cool guy.
I also like cool guy Max from California. And this is a very tropey, like...
Yeah, it was just like, okay.
90s thing where he's the cool kid with his tie-dye shirt from California. Trying to show
Salem,
off.
Salem, Massachusetts now.
We seem to have a skeptic in our midst. Mr. Dennison, would you care to share your California laid-back tie-dye point of view?
Okay. Granted that you guys here in Salem are all into these black cats and witches and stuff.
Stuff?
Fine. But everyone here knows that Halloween was invented by the candy companies. It's a conspiracy.
Because everybody's super obsessed with Halloween. He's like, I'm too cool for Halloween, man. He tries to impress Allison, and she's, like, not into it. She's like, no, thank you.
Yep. Well, although he does, like, charm her enough to get her his phone number.
But she gives it back to him.
But she had that look in her eye, like, yeah, you got it.
Like, what, she was asking for it?
No. Like, she was charmed.
I don't think she was charmed. I think she was more charmed later when she saw him, like, being a big brother. That is what charmed her.
Oh. But then he gets his shoes stolen by the local dumb toughs who are, like, the most stereotypical douchebagels.
The cemetery scene. I love the cemetery scene. This is ice.
Yeah. Oh, wait. Yeah. Instead of, like, Eugene or something like that.
Yeah, it is, like, the dumbest. And here's what I don't understand. Why do they take his shoes and not take his bike?
Maybe they just wanted shoes. Maybe he had really shitty shoes.
Wouldn't a bike be, like, more valuable?
Well, you wear shoes every day, so no, I would disagree.
And I guess they were nice, fancy California shoes.
They were just Nikes. Well, not just Nikes, but, I mean, that's what I mean. Maybe he was wearing some pretty shabby shoes.
Fair enough. I thought you would appreciate the two bullies, though. I thought you'd really enjoy that.
Yeah, I did. It's pretty stupid. So he goes home and he's pouting. And his little sister scares him after he's trying to fuck his pillow named Allison.
Oh, Allison, you're so which soft.
Was really.
No, dude actually does that. Like, sits in your room.
Oh, I'm going to start banging my pillow.
Like, oh, Allison, you're so soft. You make me just want to, oh, Daddy scared me.
And then he's acting like a little bitch about taking his sister trick-or-treating.
Which is just so dumb. Like, it's not that big of a deal.
Yeah.
What else are you going to do? You don't have any friends.
So he does it anyways. And then he gets punked by Jay and Ice again. And Danny's highly disappointed in him because her older brother's a little bitch.
I would be disappointed in him too. I'd be like, what the fuck is wrong with you?
So she's like crying like, oh my God, like, what the fuck? This guy's supposed to be protecting me, and he's a little bitch.
Yep, and he apologizes to her, and...
And they end up going trick-or-treating still, and they show up to Allison's house, who...
Is her rich. Parents,
well, not only are they rich, but they're into some weird, kinky, old-timey Salem from back in the day family bullshit.
It's really weird, because it's a Halloween party, but everybody's dressed up, like...
In wigs.
In wigs, and, like, 18, her mom used to run the museum, so they're, like, the old family of the town.
That's what I mean. They're the weird, old, creepy family of the town that's into some,
like,
weird shit.
They're actually witches. Allison's actually a witch, yeah, probably.
Well, they do call her a white witch later, but...
Well, just because of the song, And so she's super impressed. She's like, oh my God, you're so cute with your little sister. And he's like, oh, let's go out to the scary house.
Yeah, and his little sister's like, you got some rockin' tits, and my brother thinks you got rockin' tits,
Is the weirdest thing. And she's like, what do you call them? Yabos? Who calls them yabos?
I don't know that I've ever heard that other than movies. Like,
there's other movies that refer to...
Yeah, I think there's some other movies that have said yabos. I think other Disney movies maybe even have said yabos.
Yabos.
Maybe it's a Southern California thing.
By the way, Danny, I love your costume.
Thank you. I really like yours, too. Of course, I couldn't wear anything like that because I don't have any... What do you call them, Max? Yabos? Max likes your yabos. In fact, he loves them.
Maybe that is a Southern California thing. Interesting. So they go to the old house, and then Max, of course, is an idiot. Oh, look, I found a lighter. Let me light this candle. Would you think that some dumbass would have done this?
Well, no, that's not quite it, though. He was doing it. She turned the lights on. And then he said, well, if I light the candle, they'll come back, right? Like, I gotta do it, right? Bruh. Come on, bruh.
But
and they're, like, both trying to leave.
It would have happened at some point in 300 years before this.
No, this is what happened. There weren't as many lighters back in the day.
Maybe not as many virgins.
No, way more virgins, less lighters.
Okay, fair enough.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
So he's like, bro.
Yeah.
And then everything goes wild.
Yeah, they come back and it's all crazy and they're hiding.
But Mary can smell children.
Mary can smell children. It's her special gift. That's what I mean, because she's all... Like, wouldn't she smell the other two also?
Well, I would imagine that the youngest one would smell the strongest, right?
Oh, that's probably true. So maybe the smell fades as you age.
And I have a feeling, based on the way this movie goes, Allison wasn't a virgin, and maybe she's no longer a child in that case.
Oh, that's why she was like, no, I'm not going to light the candle.
Yeah, exactly. She's like, no, bitch, not me.
That's actually pretty good.
It's probably true, too.
Yeah, that is probably true. Let's see. So they like not really fight them.
No, they definitely fight them.
But fight them and
Zap. Kind of fight them off a little more. And then Thackary Binx shows up.
The cat, and he's like, get the book, I can talk.
Yeah, run, get the book.
Oh, because Max tricks them by, like,
he lights up the sprinkler, yeah.
Right, and they're freaked out because he tells them it's, like, acid water or something.
He says it's, like, the rain of death or something.
Yeah, and they're dumb. Like, they're really fucking dumb.
Well, they should be dumb. They're 1693 witches.
I know, but it's just they're so dumb. So many times in this movie, they're so dumb.
What movie have you seen that witches aren't dumb?
Harry Potter, hello.
It's not really witches, though. Like,
is Hermione not a witch?
These kind of witches.
Okay, fair enough.
Old-timey witches where there is no such thing as a wizard.
Fair enough. So, Thackeray takes them to the cemetery because witches can't set foot in there.
They can
fly over it. And so the witches come and they decide to dig up the, he's like the ex-boyfriend of Winifred.
Billy Masterson or something.
Billy Butcherson.
Oh, Butcherson, there we go.
But he was cheating on Winnie with Sarah, and that's why she sewed his mouth shut.
Well, because Sarah will fuck anything.
Well, right. But it's like, why would she even think he would do anything for her?
Well, he clearly did, because he's chasing the children.
But it's not clear, like...
He's trying to get them.
Or is he just trying to get his mouth unstuck?
Well, no, he was trying to get them at first. If he was just trying to get his mouth unstuck, that's the first thing he would have done. I think as time went on, he realized, what am I doing?
This is dumb.
Yeah.
Okay, fair. That's fair enough. And so they go underground, and I'm, like, thinking, why don't you just stay underground in here until dawn?
Well, there are many, many problems.
Like, nothing would happen. They would never find you. You could easily fend off Billy, just knock off his fucking head a couple times, and then nothing would happen. But they don't do that. And you'd think that Thackeray would know that. He would have the inside scoop.
He'd have the dope.
I don't know.
Well, they want to get out of there. Binx gets run over immediately after the sisters get on a bus with some pervo bus driver.
Yeah, he's, we'll come back to that in a second. Did you think that he was dead?
Oh, yeah, sure.
The cat?
Yeah, why not?
Because, of course, he's not. And then his stomach pops back up, and he's like, oh, I hate it when that happens.
Yeah, I've been hit by so many cars.
Because I can't die, except for I can.
Well, when the spell's broken, sure.
He can't die. So, yeah, the bus driver. Because he's got Sarah Jessica Parker on his lap. And he's like, ooh, speed bump.
And yeah.
That means he had a boner.
Children.
Hey, that may take me a couple of tries, but I don't think that'd be a problem. I'll fall enough.
Mom! Thank you.
I need one of those instant ice packs. You girls are giving me a fever. Yow.
Well, yeah, no shit.
There was just a lot of sexual innuendos in this movie.
Well, yeah, but this whole movie was very bizarre for a Disney movie. It does not fit any Disney movie kind of anything.
No, it's just different.
Yeah.
They pull the bus over because Mary smells a bunch of kids, and they don't understand that all the kids in masks are kids and not goblins.
Yeah, they're, like, confused as to why there's all these...
Because Halloween used to be this scary thing.
All Hallows Eve.
Right. And then they see Satan, or what they think is Satan.
Yeah, so...
It's actually Gary Marshall.
Well, some people would say he's Satan, but they're weirdos. They find the devil and they go into him, the master. And the kids go to a cop. Oh, yeah. Like, oh my god. But it wasn't really a cop, it was fake cop.
Oh, are you a virgin?
Yeah, I can tell.
Nope, it does not.
So then we get the best scene in the movie, where Kathy and Jimmy's watching Satan's TV.
It's like that dumb commercial. It was a real commercial. It's like the baby's like running in the thing, and it's like, dude, this got that, you know, flat, whatever, it's crazy song.
Yeah.
I don't know. It's some carpet cleaning commercial, but And she's like eating Cheetos, and the wife comes downstairs and sees Sarah Jessica Parker dancing with Satan, and Satan's like, he's trying to get down, clearly. He's like,
they call me master.
Like, he's not bothered by this at all.
No, no. And before, she was like smoking cigarettes and shooting her drink down before she went upstairs.
And she has all these rollers in her hair, and they think she's Medusa. They're like, Satan's snakes. Married Medusa. See yeah. the snakes in her hair?
Like, you must not talk to the master like this.
And so she kicks them out of the house while the dog kicks them out of the house.
Mm-hmm.
And then Bette Midler, Winifred, is like, you idiots. It's not.
She figures it out. She figures yeah. out Halloween is like a
night of frolic.
Yeah, it's become a night of frolic.
So
they go to their mom and dad.
Okay, and it's unclear because the mom and dad are at the town hall, this big dance party. It's unclear how the witches track them down to the town hall.
So that's one of the weird jump cut things. Like, where
how did they figure out they were there? They
skipped some kind of scene that connects these two dots.
Because you think with all the kids running around, they couldn't smell.
And why would they just keep going, well, I guess the book.
They need the book. They can't do the spell without the book. That's the whole thing.
But yeah, there's a huge disconnect there.
Yeah.
And the parents are just like, oh, ha, ha, ha. But where in the world does a party like this exist?
I think it's a very well, okay, they're
maybe
on
maybe Salem,
they're yeah. on the East Coast, and I do think that this kind of like the whole town gets together for a party kind of thing is more popular on the East Coast, and I think it's more popular in smaller towns.
East Coast listeners, please tell us.
It right, it's just not a thing here where everyone hates everyone.
And they have trick-or-treating in the backs of cars on the Saturday before Halloween.
Oh, on the East Coast?
Here.
Oh, here.
Yeah.
Isn't that a thing all over the place, the trunk or treat?
I think it's a terrible idea, but yeah.
It's weird. Like, here, little kid, come to the back of my car. It's weird.
Yeah, I wouldn't do it. Let's see here.
So they're at the dance party, and the parents don't believe them, of course, so...
They're like, oh, ha, ha, ha. So Max jumps up on stage, takes the mic away from the singer, and is like, oh, there's witches coming, blah, 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 blah. But Winifred masterfully plays into
the song.
It just being a song, the song the guy had been singing previously, and turns it into like an intro for the witches.
Thank you, Max, for that marvelous introduction. I put a spell on you, and now you're mine. You can't stop the things I do. I ain't lying.
No! No! Don't listen to him!
Been 300 years, right down to the day. Now the witch is back, and there's hell to pay. I put a spell on you.
Good joke. Happy Halloween.
Thanks a lot.
No, man, I'm serious. You got your head in your head.
I'm not kidding. Head in your head.
To be an and she casts an actual spell.
Yeah, she gets
them.
Up on stage and is singing and casts an actual spell on the entire room.
I love this part. I think it's so fun. The kids are like,
cover your ears. Well, they don't have their ears covered as they're running away.
No, they don't.
So, what?
Well, maybe it's that you have to listen to the whole song and they got out before the song was over.
Maybe, I don't know.
But this is like, this is one of the most iconic scenes in the entire movie when people
that makes sense.
Talk
that makes
about
sense.
This movie. Because
yeah.
it is very fun. I think it's very
yeah,
fun.
Yeah, no, it's pretty good. It's pretty good.
And so then there, I completely forgot about this whole segment.
Going to the school?
I completely forgot about it. Don't know how, but...
It's a prison for children, which is true.
And again, how do they smell them if there's kids running around everywhere? You wouldn't...
Right, it's one of those things that, again, there's... How did they even know to leave the party to go find them? There's something missing.
I don't know.
But they do, and they get trapped in the kiln.
Oh yeah, because it was Allison's idea.
And so they light the witches on fire and they're dead.
Allegedly. When really you can see the green smoke coming out of the top. And so you're like, did you actually think they were dead?
I thought this was the end of the movie.
You thought
like,
this was
oh,
the end
this,
of the movie?
This is anticlimactic.
No, of course not. So they go back to Max's house.
Yeah, they go to Max's house, like, oh, Mom and Dad still are home. That's weird. They must be having a blast.
And dumb Allison decides, I'm going to open the book because we need to help Thackary Binx not be a cat, because Thora Birch is like, you're going to be my cat forever and my children's children's cat. It's not weird at all that you're actually a teenage boy trapped in the body of this cat. It's not weird at all.
You're a Denison now, Binx.
Which you think, if the witches were dead, that would, and they would know that would break the spell. Like, Thackary would know. Because he seems to know at the very end of the movie all along. Like, it just doesn't make any sense.
So, yeah, they're sleeping together.
Yeah.
LOL. And it's like, oh, JK, you can't burn a witch.
Nope. And so Bette Midler's like, oh my god, I need my book. I need it to show itself. Allison opens the book, and the book, like, lets a light go up. But they can't see the light. Only the witches can see the light.
Well, first, the witches catch Jay and Ice and bring them back, and they try and make it without the book.
Then she opens the book. Right. Yeah.
And then it's on like Donkey Kong.
Because they go in, and Max is like, we're going to walk Allison home. And right at that moment, all the witches break in and kidnap Danny.
And the book.
And the book. And Thackary Binx.
And Thackary Binx.
You think they would leave Thackary Binx there?
They wanted to kill him.
Right, so why wouldn't they just kill him? Well, he can't die.
Well, they're torturing him. They put him in a bag on the fireplace.
Okay, they just wanted to be dicks. Got it.
They're witches.
Sarah breaks off, and then she's singing and luring a million children.
Well, yeah, she's able to lure all the town's children,
which, it's 5 a.m., and no parents are awake. Oh, they're all at the town hall party. That's right. Okay, yeah, never mind. Yeah, That's right. Everyone's at the party dancing.
Except for the weirdos that are Allison's parents who are having a weird sex party.
Right. And they're just tired because they've had too much.
Well, they're in the middle of it probably still.
Sick. Drive to the house and they decide to trick the witches again that it's light out.
Yeah, daylight savings time, witches.
They wouldn't know what that means.
Exactly. But they're tricked because they're dumb.
Right, because they turn the light on from the car, then, oh my god, the sunrise!
That they put some kind of weird tint on the headlights.
Right, to make it look like it was the sun.
Yeah.
So, they get away. Why they can't just keep driving? Because they already know that they just have to make it till sunrise, because Winifred had said, we need to do this before sunrise.
Well,
because that's why they turned the car lights on, to make them think it was sunlight. So they know that. So I'm saying, just keep driving the fucking car.
Well, they could have done that, but the witches would have survived if the witches wouldn't have made the mistake of, oh no, I want Danny because she called me ugly.
Oh, that's right, because they already made the potion.
They could have caught all those kids and lived forever.
Right. No, I forgot about that. She had a vial of potion, and it's like, the two sisters are like, there's these guys here, and there's all of these children. Yeah,
they could have sucked those guys out, and then made more potion, and then sucked everything else out.
Well, they would have just sucked one kid out, and they would have been fine.
Well, for that day, that's what I mean.
Yeah.
But then they would have been able to continue their operations.
Nope.
But nope, they had to have Danny.
Winifred had to have Danny. So they're driving the car to the cemetery again. Don't know why they don't just go underground again. You know, that would make too much sense.
Yep.
And so then Billy decides he's fed up with it, so he decides to help them. So they're fighting, and then all of a sudden, Winifred, like, gets Danny on the broom, but then, the potion gets knocked loose.
Because Thackary Binx comes up and knocks it out of her hand.
Oh, right. And so then Max.
Interchangeable names, honestly.
Right. And how confusing would that be to have Zach and Thackary?
Yeah.
Wouldn't have been confusing at all.
Yeah. Or even Zach and Max. Ooh.
Right. He decides to drink the potion.
Well, it was a smart move on his part, because then, well, he's definitely saved his sister at that point.
Well, but here's what I don't understand is, I guess, like, why wouldn't, I mean, she's like, oh, you smashed it, I'll kill her. What is she going to do to her?
Well, I think here's where I was thinking, like, that, okay, he didn't smash it because he didn't know if there was a way that she could, like, recover it. You know what I mean? Like,
okay. Like, well, she said, smash it and I'm going to kill her.
No, I know, but still, you know.
Yeah.
By drinking it, he gave her a reason to come after him rather than kill.
Danny.
Danny, yeah.
Right. And so she comes after him, and...
And she is kind of sucking his soul a little. He's, like, turning clear.
And there's a part where he's dangling off the broom, and I'm like, just fucking let go of the broom!
I think she was supposed to be holding him on to the broom.
But there was one part
where... But I know what it looks like, but I think that that's technically... She was supposed to be, like, hanging on to him. Because, yeah, he could have just let go.
Right. But he does fall to the ground eventually. She falls to the ground. Doesn't turn to stone immediately.
Yeah, very huge plot hole.
Doesn't make sense.
Yeah.
She's able to start sucking him. And then the sun comes up, and she turns to stone.
Because she's on the ground, but her sisters explode into dust.
Right. And then she explodes. The stone explodes.
Oh, that's right. The stone explodes. I forgot about that.
And... Then they're like, oh, yay, everything's great. And then Danny's like, where's Binx? Where's Binx? And then she's like, oh, my God, no, you can't die. Blah, blah,
and she's
blah.
Laying on this cat's corpse, which is right. Really gross.
It's before she's laying on a teenage boy inside of a cat's body. It is gross. The whole situation is gross.
Yeah, true.
And, like, did he mate with other cats when he was a cat? Who knows?
Let's hope so. He's not still a virgin. Well. He's using his barbed cock.
Gross. So then he's like a ghost person, and he's like, Danny, don't be sad for me. It's okay.
Yeah, it was their Star Wars moment.
Right. And then she's like, oh, and he's like, you set me free, blah, blah, blah.
And then his sister shows up.
Yeah, and they walk away. And
it took you so long.
Thackary Binx, what took thee so long?
It took 300 years for a virgin.
They had to throw that candle. In there. They had to throw it in there again. And that's the end of the movie. And we assume that then Max is not a virgin much longer.
Let's hope not.
After this, we don't know for sure, but...
They trauma bonded and they got married.
Yeah. And then that's
probably what Hocus Pocus 2 is
he's
about.
He's in their weird 1800s sex party.
Yeah. Wigs, bitches.
What you got?
So my first award is the Sarah Jessica Parker Annual... Overact Yourself Off the Goddamn Screen Award for just being an absolute hack of an actress that can't act and overacts.
I think it's
the fuck out of everything.
She does. I 100% agree, but I find so it bad. To be entertaining.
Yeah, because it's a nostalgia thing. If you would have watched this fresh today like I did, you'd be like, what is this bitch doing?
Probably. Probably true. I thought we had some kind of award for, like, worst villain ideas, but I couldn't find it, so...
Yeah, no, I don't think we do.
I just said, Winifred, worst villain ideas ever. Because the thing of, you could have taken any of those other children...
Lived forever.
And been fine. But nope, you had to have Danny, because you're an idiot.
You had to have revenge. It's basically... That is, like, a huge villain trope in a lot of movies.
It's the dumbest fucking thing ever. It's so stupid. Yeah. Like, it's just irritating.
Live to fight another day!
Right.
My tropey-trope-tastic bullies is my second award.
I'll throw that in with mine. The same kind of thing. The 90s called that wants its tropes back. Because, like, yeah, the villain tropes are... It's pretty bad. Like
Not even villain, just the bullies. Just...
Well, the bullies,
two
yeah.
idiotic Massachusetts asshole, parentless, toothless little fucking kids.
Hollywood!
Yeah, just mass holes.
It's pretty bad. But, yeah, that and just the whole, oh, I'm a cool kid from California and I moved to the small town and my life sucks.
Yeah,
and,
yeah.
You know, it's just all of it is very tropey, which is part of what I love about the movie is how tropey and dumb it
is. That's fair.
I have the zero weirdness here for Danny being like, I'm going to take care of you forever and ever. I don't care that you're a teenage boy inside of a cat's body. It's not weird at all.
I don't think that's weird.
It's a little fucking weird. Like
they trauma bonded.
It's weird.
Lots of trauma bonding.
And how are you going to explain this to your kids? Oh, this cat never dies. Oh, I know
you can just pretend like it dies every 13 years. Make it like really witchy, like every 13 years. Oh, this black cat died. Oh, look at our new black cat.
Maybe I don't know what. Be like, okay, this is what she does. She goes, okay, Binx, you got to go out, and I'm going to run you over with the car this time. I'm really sorry.
Right.
And then we'll just be like,
oh, we're going to shoot you this time. Yeah. Something. There's going to be something that happens every time. Like, if the kids are being bad, the cat dies.
That, no, what is wrong with you?
No, you teach them a lesson.
No, that's
like Arrested Development.
No, my God, no. What else do you have?
The best scene of the movie having no bearing on the rest of the movie with the devil.
Oh yeah,
scene.
Yeah,
it's just its own standalone piece. It's the best part of the movie, but it has nothing to do with the movie at all.
Pretty much, other than just showing them being just ignorant of Halloween in the real world.
Right, but it's funny. It's okay. Gary and Penny Marshall.
Yeah.
It's just, it's great. It's fantastic.
Gary Marshall is amazing at any movie.
I think Penny Marshall's also amazing.
They're just so fantastic.
Yeah.
Just wonderful. My last one is the Cloris Leachman.
I could have had that.
Way too horny award for Sarah Jessica Parker's. Because like even at the dance party, she's making out with some guy.
Yeah.
She, you know, anytime a boy comes on, oh, a boy, let me play with him. Like, she's just down to clown. Like, if she tried to light that candle, the candle would disintegrate, probably. Yeah, probably. Because she is not.
Well, maybe if she's ever actually managed to get it in there, who knows?
She was getting down with Billy.
Oh, well, cheating can go along a lot of different ways.
That's true. I mean, I guess back then it could have been they were just like holding hands or something.
Or kissing or something, yeah.
True.
My last one is the Whitey death fake out for both Thackary Binx and the witches.
Yeah, that's pretty good. A
double fake out of deaths.
That's pretty good, yeah. Because, like, yeah, I guess if you... I mean, I knew he didn't die, obviously, because I knew at the very end.
I didn't know either one. I thought that was the end of the movie. I was like, oh, that's really anticlimactic.
No, of course. And they probably wanted you to be like, oh, and then yeah. I'm so surprised.
They did a good job of that. Like, I was like, oh, okay.
Yep. Surprise or disappointment?
Not the biggest heavy hitter of a movie that I thought it was going to be. Is a little oversold. Not by you, but just by the world in general is a little...
It's a cultural...
little oversold of touch what point. It is. Yeah, I'm sure it was, but it's still a little like, okay, hang on, this wasn't like...
Okay, but you have to have some of those movies, too, that you watch when you were a kid.
And right, but I'll happily admit it.
Oh,
that's
no,
the
David,
thing.
Okay, Dee, I admit that this movie is not a great movie. I admit that.
See, that's what I mean. It's like, I'll happily be like, oh, yeah, you know, I really like this one as a kid, but it's not that good of a movie. This is, like, them making a second one 30 years later, I'm like, why?
Because
that doesn't really
because
we
it's,
didn't need
it's
it.
The age of remakes and reboots.
I know, but nobody
and...
needed that.
No, like, nobody needed it.
I don't get it.
Remember?
Yeah, no shit.
My biggest surprise.
Surprise, surprise. Surprise, surprise.
Surprise confession that I was just like, what was wrong with your little tiny kid brain? I thought that human Thackary Binx was so fucking cute when I was a little kid.
Yeah, he was kind of hot.
No, he's not. He's got an ugly face.
No, I get it. He's really fresh-faced.
I thought he was, like, the cutest person, and then
that's perfect for a little girl, though, is a really fresh-faced teen kid.
It was just the voice, I think. Is like, Thackary.
Thackary.
Emily.
Emily.
But that, yeah, I was surprised by that, because I was in my head, like, oh, yeah, it has that hot kid, and then that's Thackary Binx. And then when he first comes on screen, I was like, ew, what was wrong with you? What is wrong with you?
What about a remake or a sequel, even though we got a sequel?
We did get a sequel. I have no idea what happens.
We don't have to watch it, though, right?
No, it was a Disney Plus thing. Yeah. The sequels, and the only thing I know about the sequel is, like, none of the original people are in it, except for the three witches. Like, Thora Birch was supposed to be in it, and she couldn't do it because of scheduling conflicts.
That
you know,
means she didn't want to do it.
Right.
Because she has weird tits.
Which kind of just makes it dumb, because it would have been cool if it was like, oh, Danny's grown up.
Yeah,
the witches
are
back, and now she has to go and with her kids or whatever. Like, that could have been cool, but...
So you want it to be like a Peter Pan 2, what's that
Yeah,
movie?
A Return to Neverland. Yeah, like, Return to Neverland. That's what I mean. Scenario. Like, it could have been cool, but... And, like, if Thackary Binx didn't actually, like, get freed or whatever, and he's still a cat...
I would have remade it and just connected some dots. Like, let's make this make sense.
Right. I don't know how exactly, but...
I can think of some ways, but... Like not cutting out the scenes that connect the scenes together.
Okay, sure. I just thought you made a specific
No. All those examples. All those places where it's like a jump cut of what just happened? How did the witches find them?
The biggest one is when they get the town hall party. That's the biggest one.
That's what I mean. There is clearly something they filmed and chopped out of that.
Maybe the idea is that Mary smells like a lone child.
No.
Because there's a bunch of adults there.
There has to be something more than that. And something more to find them after they leave that party. It
doesn't make sense.
Any final thoughts?
It's just good old-fashioned, cheesy, campy nostalgia.
I think it's for the birds. Meaning it's for chicks.
Well, yeah, because every chick is like, oh my god. Anything with witches is like...
What's up, witches?
Well, because, yeah, dudes' things are like superheroes and like, or, you know, cowboys or pirates. Like, that's very much like a dude thing.
Dude.
Like, every little boy wants to be like a cowboy or a pirate. Every little girl wants to be a witch or a princess. It's just a thing.
What if you're a little boy and you wanted to be an Indian?
Well, either way, I'm just saying, it's those types of things are ingrained in you from childhood.
That's fair, dog. That's fair. Did you get a budget for this movie?
Yeah, is $28 million, and they only made $50 million. I wonder why.
Well, maybe if you released it not in July.
Right.
But it was like watching it now in February as we record this. Like, Halloween movie just does not feel like anything right now. It's like, okay.
I even my pumpkin beer didn't help that much.
Yeah.
But...
Yeah, very little helping with that. So what do you think the Rotten Tomatoes score for this movie
With the critics? It's probably like a 50%.
40 with the critics.
Well, that's a little harsh.
It's a little harsh. It's a little much.
It's a little much.
It's got 72 with the people, so it recorrects.
As it should. As it should.
Kat, what is your score?
I fully acknowledge this score is deeply rooted in nostalgia. But I found so many parts of the movie I was smiling and being happy because I was like, oh my god, so many memories of watching this movie as a child. So I gave it a 78%.
Holy shit.
Or 7...
Whoa. Man.
Shush. 7.8 out of 10 unnecessary emphasis and times we are reminded of Max's virginity.
Fair enough. I'm not close to that. I was trying to be as generous as possible, and it's still not that great of a movie. I gave it a 55.
It's better than I thought you were going to score it. Because, okay, I knew going into
this... Well, it's not terrible. It's just not good either.
It's just so fun. I just find it so fun.
It's fairly fun. Yeah.
And future children will watch this movie. They're going to watch all of my childhood favorites.
I don't know if kids now are going to like this movie. This is kind of a tough sell.
You got to get them while they're young.
Get them while they're young. Yeah, still, it's a...
You got to suck them into the my favorite things when they're young. So they can be different.
I don't understand that instinct, but that's your own call.
No, because you got to get them so they're different. They're not... You really want them growing up and watching dumb shit like Bluey.
But, well, yeah, because that's what kids watch. Ugh. They have to have their own stuff, not your stuff. Ugh.
So they got to have good stuff.
Yeah. Let's watch some Tom and Jerry, kids.
Okay, we'll just let them watch Caillou.
Not that. No whiny bitches.
Oh, yeah.
All right, so we're still at 420, bro, right?
Yep. Okay.
No new movie on the horizon, I guess, except for Moana 2 now.
No, there's a... I feel like there's one more coming out. There's a couple more coming out, but not for a while.
All right, so how about number 417? That's a new movie.
Is it the new Haunted Mansion?
It's not. I don't know if this is a real thing.
It's probably a real thing.
I don't think so.
It's something that we would have added.
Well, yeah, but we added some of these.
Is it Elemental?
No. Some of these we added are Disney Plus movies.
Okay, what is it?
It's Strange World. I don't know what that is.
That's a real thing. It came out, like, the week that the pandemic started.
It says 2023.
Oh, wait. So, no, it came out, like, right when movies were coming back to theater. People started going to theaters again.
Are you sure it came out in theaters?
Yes, I'm sure it came out.
Double check before we...
I don't need to double check.
Okay.
Yes, it came out in theaters. November 23rd, 2022.
Limited release?
No!
Okay. So, strange world it is. I don't know. It's going to be strange because I don't know what it is.
I loosely know what it is, but I don't know anything about the plot. I don't know who's in it.
Is it animated?
Yes, it's animated.
Oh, weird. Okay.
Yeah.
Wow. So next week, Strange World. Cool.
Ghost it's a world. Strange world.
So in the meantime, like, subscribe, do stuff.
Leave us a review on your podcast platform of choice and let us know if you enjoy Hocus Pocus as much as I did or not as much like Dee did.
Yeah.
If you have, it's just so bizarre that you've never seen it. It's just so it's weird to me.
It's not weird.
It's weird. It's weird.
It came out when I was 13 where I could not have cared less about some dumb chicks.
But it's just
Halloween
bizarre
movie.
That you wouldn't have like caught it some, like, I remember being like a young adult and being at like Halloween parties and somebody would just have this playing in the background of some TV somewhere.
I wouldn't have been at that party.
It's no, like, it would just be like on TV.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. That's not the kind of party I would have been at.
Ooh, it was too cool. I was more like ice.
Yeah, fair enough. All right, so this has been Disney Odd Pod.
I'm Kat.
I'm Dee.
Bye!
Exactly what I thought was yeah. there.
I was like, oh, you like these, that'll work.
Yeah. All right, Broncos.
What do you mean, all right, Broncos?
Exactly what I said.
Isn't the season over?
Yeah, that's the best time right now. It's all hope, man.
Is it the draft or something?
Well, not yet, but I mean...
Oh. I just thought there was something specific that happened that you were like, all right.
No.
All right, because.
But, I mean.
Fuck Patrick Mahomes.
It's likely that I won't have to deal with Russell Wilson anymore.
Oh, poor Russ.
Well, he's not really unbeatable. I mean,
they no, get he's
extremely
not.
Lucky to win this time.
You know what? It's romance magic. That's what it is. It was in the stars.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, if that punt doesn't hit that dude's leg, there is no way that they win.
We're watching a real-life American fairy tale play out yeah. before our eyes. Just be thankful.
If that one guy didn't tear his Achilles just running onto the field.
Oh, jeez.
I mean, come on. It took magic to make it happen.
Taylor Swift magic. She's up there in the booth. Like, she's like Severus Snaping the football.
I need to get some, like, white filler for the...
You having a hard time seeing? Sponsored by Ace Pumpkin Cider. So festive.
Is that why you got that?
I've had it. This has still been in the fridge forever.
No. I meant like... God,
yeah, that's why. Of course it is. I'm trying to feel in the season. And it's delicious. It's the one that tastes more like a real pumpkin. And not like the fake pumpkin stuff.
Like a squash?
Yeah. Do you want to taste it?
No.
Nah.
Bernard McKee BT.